The Philippine Appellate Court rules cyber libel cases can be filed within 15 years from the date of publication. The Court of Appeals' 4th Division made the assertion, injuncting the bid of Rappler CEO Maria Ressa and a former writer-researcher to overturn a cyber libel conviction against them. Ressa argued such cases can only be filed within 1 year from the publication of the supposed libelous article. But as CA explains, the cybercrime law has increased the penalty for cyber libel. The case against Ressa was filed by businessman Wilfredo Keng, who was mentioned in a Rappler article about a former chief justice facing an impeachment trial. The article was published in 2012, but Keng did not file his complaint until years later. The CA also held Keng was a private person and that the defamatory statements against him are presumed malicious.
Justice Secretary Boying Remulla and Solicitor General Minardo Guevara will look into the designation of Rafael Lotilia as Energy Secretary. The DOE law prohibits the appointment of an officer of a private company primarily engaged in the energy industry as Energy Chief within 2 years from retirement, resignation, or separation. Lotilia is an independent director of Aboitiz Power and Enexor.
President Marcos leads a second cabinet meeting virtually as he recovers from his second bout with COVID-19. Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles says the cabinet discussed the 2023 national budget and the infrastructure projects. She adds the meeting also included discussions on priority transportation programs. Marcos earlier said he wanted to conduct more weekly cabinet meetings to discuss the state of the country.
Inflation was the main concern of Filipinos in June. The latest Pulse Asia survey shows 57% of Filipinos wanted the Marcos administration to prioritize controlling the rise in commodity prices. The Philippines' inflation rate rose to an over three-year high of 6.1% that month. This was followed by other economic-related concerns, such as increasing wages, reducing poverty, and creating more jobs. 20% of respondents also expressed the need to fight corruption in government. The Pulse Asia survey was conducted from June 24 to 27 with 1,200 respondents nationwide.
President Marcos faces high expectations ahead of his first State of the Nation address. Business groups hope the president will be more specific about his economic plans. For the Philippine Chamber of Commerce, Marcos should prioritize job creation and human resource capacity building. It also hopes to see the peso strengthening to low 50s by the first quarter of next year. Despite record high inflation rates and surging oil prices, the PCCI said talks with its counterparts in neighboring countries show that the Philippines is still in the radar for investment.
Investors now are in a position, they are eager to know what the new administration is preparing for the next 6 years. So the sentiment of foreign investors, and I'll just talk about the foreign investors, they want to see what the new administration, the market administration has to offer, or what the Philippines has to offer. So they're all ears now, and it's a good opportunity for us as a country. This is the time that we should lay down our programs together, not only with the government, but also the private sector. If the foreign investors see that government and the private sector are working together, opening up the Philippines, I believe it's a good sign for investors.
The Philippines marks the sixth anniversary of the Hague ruling on the South China Sea arbitration. The award was the culmination of the Philippine government's legal battle against China's supposed nine-dash line. The Permanent Court of Arbitration ruled in favor of the Philippines, upholding Manila's sovereign rights and jurisdiction in its exclusive economic zone. Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo says the award is final and indisputable. He also asserts the Philippines wants and is committed to maintaining a peaceful South China Sea. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken also marking the occasion. He reiterated America's call for China to abide to international rules and cease its provocative behavior. That's as he reaffirms any armed attack on the Philippines in the South China Sea would invoke U.S. commitments under the Mutual Defense Treaty.
Political analyst Dindo Manhit believes President Marcos should strengthen ties with other countries in dealing with China's aggressive stance in the West Philippine Sea. Manhit notes there are countries and groups willing to work with the Philippines when it comes to asserting the country's rights in the disputed area.
When you look at strengthening alliances, imagine if you're a country that builds on your external defense, working with countries that believe that you have the right over those territories. You have the right over those exclusive economic zones. Imagine if we do joint patrols with countries within the Asia-Pacific region that share our values of rules based. Imagine if we continue to build up our own military, not to strengthen us, with the help of countries. When we look at our Navy, there's enough engagement with countries, not only from our neighbors, but also even the European Union, hoping to work with us in building our capacity.
Some fisherfolk groups also marking the Hague ruling. Pamalakaya held a synchronized coastal protest this morning, challenging President Marcos to assert the country's claims in the West Philippine Sea. Meanwhile, around 30 fishing boats conducted a fluvial parade at Laguna de Bay, urging China to leave Philippine waters.